what is the necessary condition. Okay, it is not perpendicular, but what is the necessary condition? Now, they Google. Of course, they Google, but at least they understood also. And at least then they started to feel at least constraints. What are these constraints? Actually, that's how mathematicians develop mathematics. Euclidean talked about only planar figures. Then somebody, when it came to non-Euclidean, says, oh, if on a plane then I can have a triangle, this is an estimation. I can have a triangle on a ball itself. A ball can be triangle as that. It will look like this. Convergence signs. That gave idea to a non-Euclidean geometry, not a planar geometry, which is, you know, something else. So what if these constraints are taken off? What if I don't have a square base? What if I don't have a regular figure at my base? What if I don't have my equal triangles? What if? So these what ifs, starting even more like this. And then they said that you do this and I do this. Very small project, for 15 days, they picked up, somebody picked up only on square-based pyramids. Good. Square-based pyramid with all these loosening up of the constraints. Okay. And one of them started looking at decomposition. I haven't been able to touch that, but I'll just give you an idea. So one of the group also presented this. This is for Sabin ki bole. So ye jo humne decomposition maine beech mein band kar diya tha and I diverted to here. We start looking, okay, now we started chopping. I chop more, I chop more, I chop more. And we look at chopping it from the parallel. You know, somebody said that if I chop it from the diagonal, like this, when you chop it from the diagonal, you get this. And it's a little chopper. You get a rectangle. Or a parallelogram to this little chip. Imagine, when there's a plane going here. Obviously, you will get this rectangle, right? Chopping from the corner, you went on chopping from the corner. I think I don't have time, but keep on chopping from the corner and these are their projects. And then eventually you get a hexagon also. And a pentagon, by the way. Keep chopping it off. When you reach this stage, you know, you get an hexagon. So the triangle gradually keep chopping it off from the corner. This one was chopped off from the diagonal. You keep chopping it off from the corner. The corner keep increases. This. Those are increasing, right? You chopping, chopping, chopping. When you start chopping it up, then when you get this stage, you know, it crosses here. It's difficult for you to imagine right now. You can Google, it's very easy. You can just write decomposition of two things. Chop it off till here, create a hexagon. And so then they started looking, so one group started looking at the composition of cubes and what are the, they started looking at the cross section and gradually compared the cross section. The third group again came back to cubes and we looked at decomposition. Now these are the pieces in which a cube has been decomposed, it will get broken into pieces. This has been broken into pieces, now these are the faces, okay? So this has been broken like this. These become sides. So I put three, you add three more, and this become a cube. I have these pieces, you add three more, this become a cube. Okay, so you've got these smaller pyramids, right? Our smaller pyramids, but then we didn't end at that. We wanted to relate the volume of the smaller pyramids. How do you find the volume? What is the ratio of the smaller pyramid to the bigger cube? What, where you put in this line so that you get congruent pyramids? These are all congruent pyramids, right? So where is this point from which I have to chop them off so that I get that? Then volume of this. Why did I do volume of this? Okay, that another way of chopping was this. So I can show you this quickly. Where is that? These are three concrete pieces. I've got your piece. A square tilted square. So these are the faces, these are three faces, goes like this. And the third piece gets a little tricky, we get a juice of us. And you put the third piece. It's getting a little young.
Yeah.
And you put the third piece here.
Maybe with the things like
this.
Yeah.
And you get a cube. Right? So volume of this is 1/3 of volume of this. Very simple to see. It's very complicated. If the volume is going to heart attack. It's very simple to see because the height is same. And then these are the generalization that when they see that hormone to a cylinder. But it comes like a magic to them that it's one third of the volume of the cylinder. We never develop it from a square pyramid to a, actually cube is also a prism. So this is one third, and then the heights are same, the base is same, so it's going to be one third. Basically you see now it's one third. You don't have to do that sand dalne wala, and then you will, that's what the most of the textbook says. Sand dalo and it will be one third. That's just an approximation. That's not what I'm calling for. Different other sections, this is another section of the tube in which they've broken up. All three of them have only one mystery. They have to be congruent pieces. So you can find the volume that there are these four pieces. When you join them, they become a tube. This is another one and this is another one. So that was another idea that we picked up. Thank you. There are many more ideas. I can just go on and on because I feel so excited to talk about the work that my students have done. And so would you, you know, when you do something, and I'm sure you would also be so very excited. When students literally come up with ideas like this, and then you see them growing, you know, that you can spark. Oh, next year is still good. What difficult thing that happened? Not chote chote cheeze. Chote chote cheeze ka bade bade cheeze ko close kaise karenge? Activity close karenge. ये सिर्फ ब्रेक करने का मेरा पॉइंट नहीं था कि कॉन्फिडेंस उसका था वॉल्यूम देखिए